Hi guys, welcome to Live with Vi, and if you like what you see, subscribe. Hi guys, today we're doing a very different sort of live. It's a live with one of my closest friends, Nupur. She's also my business partner in Mumbai. And we want to talk about today her journey right now, currently, because she is experiencing COVID-19 symptoms. Her husband has just been tested positive for COVID. So we want to kind of get an update of what is happening live right now with her family and with her situation. We're just waiting for Nupur to join in. Guys, get ready with your questions. I have a list of questions here as well, because she has two daughters. One is almost a year and a half, and the other one is Vivansha's age, Raya. She's 7. She lives in a joint family, her mother-in-law, brother-in-law, sister-in-law, Rahul, and she. So we want to kind of understand what the situation is firsthand, because we've been hearing so much about, you know, COVID and symptoms, and how, like her brother-in-law rightly said, do not COVID shame. I think we need to now stop getting shaming and kind of quarantining the mind of our thing of being scared of COVID. So we have someone, she's so close to me, so I actually requested her, and I think it's amazing guts to come online live, especially when you're going through this. So we're just waiting for her to join and talk about her journey. Just give me 2 minutes. I've just messaged her that I've come on live. So let's wait for her to come on live. I'm sure everyone wants to know, you know, what the symptoms are, what can be done, what BMC is doing, what actually is happening currently in the house where, you know, people have these symptoms. I'm just waiting for her to join in. If you guys have any questions already, it'll be great if y'all start writing. I have a list of questions here, but then we can always, Nupur can always go through the questions on the chat as well and start talking about them in case I have missed anything. I'm going to talk about the symptoms. I'm going to talk about how they think they got it. I'm going to talk about how it is dealing with this COVID-19 with kids in the house. What is their status? What is the BMC protocol? What are the ways of testing? If it is necessary to test, what are the medications and what are the procedures they are currently following? And what is called virus shedding. So just waiting for Nupur to join in. Rashi, can you do me a favor and just give Nupur a call and tell her that I'm live so she can join in? Okay, she said she's just trying to connect. Thanks, Rashi. And you know, you hear so many things about people getting this, you don't know them. This is, yeah, I agree, Juhi, amazing for Nupur to come out and tell us about it. I think it takes a lot of guts. Yeah, hi Nopes, just waiting for her. I'm just sending her the request.
Hi Nopes,
what's up?
How are you? First, the question, how are you, is so important, right? For the first time, it genuinely means something. And I just want to say kudos to
why,
you.
Hats why are you asking you. Me how important I am? You know that I'm very important. You know that I'm very important.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The question, how are you, is so important today, you know, for me to ask you. And awesome. I mean, kudos to you. It takes absolute guts to come online right now and talk about it. I just gave everyone a brief as to what we are going to talk about. Okay. And if you read the messages, all of them have said, it, you know, thank you, Nopes, for doing this, for giving them you know, the strength or to come out and educate them, because you are currently going through it. You are going through COVID-19. You're going through the symptoms. So should we just dive right into it and start talking about it?
Yeah, I guess a lot of people have joined in. So I think we should just start. Yeah.
You know, Nopes, you won't believe it. After Monish posted his post, which I think was fantastic, and the thing that stood out was do not COVID shame. I got so many messages, so I cannot imagine your calls and WhatsApp and Instagram messages.
My WhatsApp is still open. At least on Instagram, I can just like the message and then let go of it. But on WhatsApp, I have to reply. So right now, I just have like so many messages to reply to.
So what we're going to do is we're going to save this IGTV video. Okay. So you can share it and we can share it and people can actually be educated as to what it is, what you are going through, what the symptoms are. Okay. So let's start with this. How do you think you guys got it? Who was the first person to get it and what were the symptoms?
So see, very frankly, I don't think it's too much of a mystery that we have been doing this thing, the lockdown ration thing for all the needy.
Yes.
So we've had a lot of NGOs who used to come and pick up ration packets.
Okay.
We had a lot of even the beggars who were on the roads coming from the back door, picking up the stuff.
Right.
So we had our staff, around 7-8 of them, who were quarantined in the hotel, but who were helping us making these ration packets.
Right.
So they were giving it to them, and they were using their gloves and masks. But, you know, sometimes you just feel like, okay, right, it's right here. I'll wear it later. Let me just give them this one packet and let me get done with it. It could be either that. Or then we had media people living in the hotel. We had NDTV people living who were getting out for their bites, etc.
Right.
So they could have probably been a source. Or then these guys were also in touch with the BMC and the cops. Also, guys, the BMC and the cops, they really, really need water, yeah. Because, and their name is, their reputation is so bad that nobody is even giving them water because they feel they won't be paid for it.
Right.
So we, out of goodwill, were just sending Bisleri bottles and cases and stuff like that. But in case you guys could help, just send over some Bisleri cases because they need water and they are in the front line. And they are working for us. And so we should help them in any which way possible.
Correct.
So, yeah, any which way. So, we were in touch with, my husband and my brother-in-law were in touch with them as well. So, probably it could have come through any of these three sources. We can't really pinpoint on one.
Right.
And so then, yeah, Rahul felt his symptoms first. He felt it on 19th morning.
Okay.
He decided to quarantine himself in the hotel.
So, what were the symptoms? And Rahul, I've known Rahul for more than 8 years. I've never seen him sick.
So, Rahul doesn't take allopathy at all.
Correct.
And he doesn't feel symptoms per se, like the way normally all of us feel symptoms.
Right.
He doesn't feel symptoms. So, when he started feeling something, he realized, first things first, Rahul never believed in coronavirus. Okay, the very
I know that.
His economy, his hotel was shut and his hotel was not making any money, was pissing the life out of him.
Yeah.
And he didn't believe in coronavirus. So, and he thought that he already had antibodies to it, which is clearly not true. And so when he started feeling symptoms, he realized something's up. And he packed his bag and he went to the hotel.
So what were the symptoms that he started feeling the first time?
It was a low grade fever that he started having, and after that he felt a little bit of a headache.
Okay.
And body pain, not as much.
Okay.
And cough, he started feeling a little bit. Also, Rahul is a smoker, so I guess people who are smokers, I guess, tend to feel the cough symptom way more strongly compared to the others.
Okay.
Yeah, so these were the couple of symptoms that he started feeling.
And so what about, you know, I was just going through the symptoms online. They talk about sore throat. They talk about loss of smell and loss of taste. they talk about body ache and fever. So did everyone or did all of y'all feel it slowly, or it was one at a time or all together? How, what about you?
So everybody's symptoms have been, a couple of them have been overlapping.
Okay.
But not not all. Like my cough has, touch wood, not been bad. I don't have a cold.
Okay.
But they have a cold. They have a slight cough.
Okay.
Pretty much like a recovery cough. Not like crazy incessant coughing.
Okay.
But they have a recovering cough.
Okay.
And low grade fever, yes, they all have. Body pain is one thing which is common. For
okay.
me, it was just lower body. It was
okay.
Legs and, you know, calves and thighs.
But you had the fever as well. You had the low-grade fever. You had the body pain. You had the...
Yeah, but another thing that I'll talk about is low-grade fever. So you get
yeah.
fever, which is around 99, because we have that thermometer now.
Scanner, correct.
The forehead thermometer. And you get fever. So it doesn't go above 99.2. I would say.
Okay.
Okay. And either now you take a Dolo 650.
Okay.
And your fever breaks in the next 5 minutes. When
okay.
you just start sweating like profusely.
Okay.
Or then you wait it out. And in 2 hours without taking the Dolo also you can feel fine.
Okay.
So I have got fever, say this low grade fever, on 4 occasions. 2 occasions I've taken the Dolo. 2 occasions I have not taken the Dolo.
Okay.
And the fever has still broken.
Okay. So it's not a consistent fever like a malaria or something where you constantly have...
That's not
what you all have experienced. Okay.
Yeah, not at all. Not at all. So the fever is very, very manageable, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
We all know, people who know you and me, you have Raya and Raina at home. Raina
yes.
is about 1.5. Raya is 7.5.
Yes.
How are the kids dealing with it? How are you dealing with the kids? Are the kids showing any symptoms? What is happening? Tell us about that.
So I was very worried initially before the virus.
That's the first thing I asked you when you told me.
Yeah.
How the kids are.
Yeah, a lot of people are asking me about the kids. Now, Raya, touch wood, as they are saying, kids who are between the 2 and 10 bracket are okay. It's actually true. Kids between 2 and 10 are pretty much having antibodies to it and they are fighting it. And they seem all right. So Raina had a slight fever 2 days back and she had a bad throat 2 days back. And the only thing we can give your child during a viral is what we are giving. Okay, it is Calpol 120 is what she's taking. And
okay. So you've spoken to your pediatrician about this?
Yes, I've spoken to Dr. Ajit about this. And
okay.
You're having, and he knows that we are pretty much COVID positive. So,
okay.
And he's suggested to give her Tixilix. And kids who
okay.
have wheezing, wheezing can get quite bad as well. So, but nebulizer, I feel, is not... not really told to be given to the kids at this time. I don't know what the reason is for no nebulizer.
Okay.
Also, Dr. Ajit is quite anti-giving stronger stuff to kids. So maybe
correct.
It's because of that. So you can give your Astaline or your Ventolin or whatever. And you can give your cough syrup along with it. For kids who are wheezing. Okay,
the
ones
who so Raya is
can be given
Raya has no symptoms, stuff. Right? So you've not
no.
Raya has no symptoms, touch wood. So you've not given her anything.
Raya's
now,
not
what
given.
I so tell me something is who is there in your family? I know, but for people who are logging in right now, who has got tested, and who is not tested, and who has symptoms? So if you can just go through that with us.
So, I have a very big family. I
yeah.
have my husband. I have my mother-in-law.
Right.
I have my brother-in-law. I have a newlywed sister-in-law in the house. And
right.
I have my kids and myself.
Right.
I have a father-in-law as well, guys. But my father-in-law has moved to Indore. He has gone to his Guruji's house, thankfully.
Right.
Because he is diabetic and he has a slight BP issue as well. So we are very glad that he's not around us during this time. And he's safe
right.
and sound in Indore. And the rest of us are here. And all of us are showing symptoms. Okay,
have
we have
all
a
been?
Harem of staff as well. And we have like a cook. We have two top work guys and we have my nanny as well. Now, out of all four of them, I think only one top work guy probably showed symptoms for one day. And he seems fine now.
Okay.
So, but this is what coronavirus does. Like, it gets you down for like one day. And then the second day, you're just alive and kicking and wanting to do some work.
But tell me something, Nupur. How many of y'all have been tested and how did y'all get tested?
So only two of them have been tested. That's Rahul and Monish, my husband and my brother-in-law. None of us have been tested.
Any reason why?
So we tried a lot to get a home tester, one of the diagnostics coming home to test us, because even if we don't have the virus, we'll end up contracting it at a diagnostic
testing center. Correct.
But they are very clear that if you don't have high fever and if you don't have breathlessness, we will not come and test you. Okay. Now, whatever influence you try, whatever pull you try, you're not going to get them to come home to test you unless Correct. You have very high fever or breathlessness. Okay.
So
Rahul and Monish had to go to the Marine Drive drive-through of Suburban Diagnostics to test themselves. And I didn't want to leave the kids behind. So that's why we did not go.
So tell me something. I'm reading out the questions here as we speak. I also have a list of questions. What is the BMC protocol of this? Because, you know, initial stages, they came, shut off the entire building, started spraying, you know, then you would have a barrage of WhatsApp messages saying this building is quarantined, this building. What is a BMC protocol? What have they done? And how have you all quarantined yourselves at home?
So the BMC protocol on us has been relatively much easier compared to the other buildings. I don't know the reason why, but they haven't sealed our building. And yes, they were here in 1 hour of us getting positive test results. And
so how soon did you all get your result?
48 hours.
Okay, so 2 days.
Yeah, so they went on 27th and we got our results on 29th. Yesterday was 29th morning.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so yesterday in the morning they got their result. And so then they haven't sealed our building. They have just put up a flex outside our main door saying that this is a containment area. And whatever, strict actions will be taken for those who come in and out of it. So
Right. So now I want to talk about the ways of testing. You spoke about them going to the Marine Drive testing thing. But there are options of home kits which are not available right now or they don't have it.
So those are those Chinese rapid kits.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
But those are the fake ones. So a friend of mine right now only suggested that in case you want, I can have it sent to you. But if they are fake and it's going to show me negative when I'm actually positive or vice versa, does it make sense?
Do you feel, so right now I want to know what exactly are your symptoms right now?
Today, my symptoms are I have a very slight throat pain, that's which I'm feeling only when I'm yawning, and loss of taste and smell, guys. Like a foodie like me who cannot taste her food, it's very upsetting. Whatever I'm eating, I cannot taste any of my food, and maybe something extremely salty you will feel, but I don't like salty stuff, so I didn't really enjoy that. And sweet stuff, not as much either.
Okay.
Spice, yeah. If it's really, really spicy, probably you can feel it, but still not there. So I don't know. It's very tough to taste food right now. I'm having all the jalapenos and all the paprika possible, but it's not helping.
So tell us something. Are you doing... I'm not a doctor, nor are you a doctor. Okay, so we're not going to talk about what medication you should do. But I want to know what medication you are doing. Are you doing any natural medication? And what you are doing kind of to, you know, get better? Because it's been now a while, right? 19th May, Rahul started. 10. Yes.
Yeah,
so
it's been 10 days for the rest of us. So we are having a lot of hot water. Okay, okay, that's something which everybody's advising also, and I feel personally it's helping also.
It's helping.
It's not like just a fake advice.
Right.
And lots of hot water. That could be around 6 to 7 liters of hot water in a day. Okay. Keep your bottle with you. And make sure nobody else uses your bottle. Also, we are having Beko Zinc because somebody has told us to have a B complex with zinc.
Okay.
We have been having vitamin C 1000 mg on a daily basis since our Rahul has upped his dose for some reason. I believe in just keeping it simple. So I'm keeping 1000 mg. He's made it 2000 mg. Also, he's taking HCQ, which the BMC doctor has advised him to take as of today because apparently his virus load must be more than ours. So, he's also taking HCQ.
So, he is taking it. What about steam? I've read everywhere about steaming. Are your guys doing steaming or?
So, we have been doing steaming ever since the lockdown started.
Correct, correct.
Luckily for us, we have steam in our bathroom. So, it has been very easily available also.
Correct.
So, we have been doing the steam. But not that if you do steam regularly, that you will not contract the virus.
No, but like what about that? You feel the steaming has helped you with the with getting feeling better, like your throat symptoms going, or is it more of the hot water?
More with the hot water. See, people can take the steam. There's no harm in taking steam. If at all, it'll do you good only. But it's too hot outside right now, and plus this virus comes with a lot of sweating. So, with the sweating, you want to even take steam, that's up to you. I mean, I can't take so much heat. Something happens to me. Yeah.
I still have more questions, but there are even questions on the...
Now, you finish your questions and then we'll take the ones. Yeah.
Okay. Tell me about virus shedding.
So, virus shedding, it's this concept that people who got the virus will talk a lot about it. Okay. The moment somebody contracts it now, even if I'm sitting on this chair, I'm currently shedding my virus on this chair.
Virus. So you have to keep sanitizing?
So you have to constantly sanitize your house.
Oh.
So that is a very important thing. Like when Rahul came back from the hotel after 6 days, I felt myself falling sick again. After he left, I had got the virus and I became okay in 2 days and stuff like that. After he came back in 2 days, I fell sick again. So that is because the virus load that he brought with him and that he
had.
Like my mom-in-law is shedding virus, Monish is shedding virus. So everybody is shedding their own virus. And if your immunity somehow is weaker than theirs, you tend to take it on you.
Got it.
I fell sick again 8 days after having recovered. You know? So that is something one has to be wary of and make sure that you keep sanitizing your house. Even after you have got the virus, don't think that everybody's got corona and now y'all are fine. It won't be fine as such. You have to keep sanitizing your house.
Correct. So and that is so important because... nobody has spoken about that, right? No one has told us this.
Exactly. So we've got this pump. So my guy wears this bag kind of a thing and he sprays the entire house. And especially bathrooms. Bathrooms are very, very important because that's where your virus is actually staying and breeding.
Oh, got it. Okay. So for your bathroom, you're sanitizing with the pump and everything.
Absolutely. In our house, pretty much one person is using one bathroom.
One bathroom.
Except for my bathroom now, currently, I am using it with my two daughters. Okay?
Right.
So, every time somebody uses the bathroom, we are spraying it.
Tell me something. What are you doing for the girls' immunity? Are you giving them something?
I am giving them Limsi.
Limsi.
Those are chewable vitamin C.
Correct.
Yeah. So, those are something that they are taking too easily. Because the NRC 1000 and all, I tried, but they didn't really take to it easily. So, it's something that they're taking.
Now, tell me something, Nobs. We've heard about, the older age, not being able to now, like feeling very weak with the virus. Your mother-in-law is what are her symptoms? Her symptoms are same as yours. Did it last for much longer for her? How is she doing?
So my mom-in-law is doing fine. In fact, she got it even after me. And okay. She was going to the hotel on a regular basis. I am the only one with my kids who was not going to the hotel at all.
Right.
But she was going and she got the virus after me, a day after me.
Okay.
Okay, maybe her immunity levels are higher than mine.
But what were her symptoms?
Her symptoms are again low-grade fever. Okay. But she didn't take a Dolo, she took a Sumo. Because I don't know if people know that paracetamol depends a lot on your body weight.
Correct.
So if a Crocin 500 suits you, who might be thinner than me, a Crocin 500 doesn't do anything to my fever. So I have to take a 650 mg. So my mom-in-law has been taking a Sumo, which is a way more higher mg of paracetamol.
But you know, somewhere I read that you're not supposed to take paracetamol. So that is again a debunked concept.
No, paracetamol can be taken totally. In fact, that's the only medicine that even in the hospitals they are giving. So paracetamol can be taken. Brufen should not be taken.
Okay, Brufen. So ibugesic basically. Anything with a correct.
Yeah,
okay.
And no antibiotics.
No antibiotics.
See, it's anyway a viral fever. So it's not a bacterial infection. There's nothing an antibiotic can do which ways.
Correct.
So
absolutely.
Rather not take. It's actually
sorry, go ahead.
No. I was just I just read the questions, but we'll take the questions later.
Yeah, so let's I think now we can, because there are so many questions you're already lined up. So Nick, do we want to go question by question, so at least you know we can get through a bunch of them? Hats off to Nupur. I completely agree with you all. It takes guts, it takes strength to come and talk to us like this. I don't know many people
you know
who would.
Very frankly, till the time I had not got the virus, I really wanted to know I had a lot of unanswered questions. So I rather have done this to answer everybody's questions, because since I'm already on this side, I'll be in a better position to answer everybody's questions.
Yeah,
because
but
there's so much hype and panic around this virus. And I've had so many virals. Trust me, this has been so easy, touch wood, that this is actually not a big deal.
Correct. So let's go to the first question. Hey, Nupur, how are you doing and how is everyone feeling at home? I think she just answered it.
Yeah, a lot of questions I've already answered. But any which ways, I'm feeling fine, touch wood. And everybody at home has also pretty much recovered. Rahul and Monish obviously have recovered the fastest. And that's my cousin sister, Nikita. She's a doctor. She's a surgeon. She's an oncologist. Okay. Yes. So they have recovered the fastest. And so we're all okay in the house, touch wood. Virus shedding is happening, but we are sterilizing everything.
So everywhere you all sit, as soon as you'll get up, you'll start sanitizing the place?
Pretty much. Like post breakfast, we will sterilize the entire living room.
So you all are using that pump?
So it's like a bag.
The hand pump.
Bag. Yeah, so you wear it on your shoulders. And then you just go spraying everything.
Go around. Correct. We have that too. So I think this part, Juhi, the question has been answered. Who all have the virus? I'm confused about that part. So Monish and Rahul have tested positive.
Yeah, we are the only ones tested themselves.
Correct.
But we all have the virus 100%.
Okay. How did you guys get tested? We went through that, but you want to just quickly tell them?
So there's a drive-through of Suburban Diagnostics. This is if you guys don't want to go to the center. Like we didn't want to go to the center. So they went to the drive-through of Suburban Diagnostics, which is on Marine Drive. And that's how they got themselves tested. After 2 days, they got the result.
Okay. What was the test? How did they test?
It's a nasal swab test. So literally 2 seconds, you're in and out.
Correct. So you have quarantined yourself at home. You don't need to get admitted to the hospital.
Yes. So we have all quarantined ourselves at home. And see, very frankly, they don't have beds, so they don't even really want to offer you any hospital. And they did really insist that we quarantine ourselves in the hotel, especially Rahul and Monish. But they had already done their first 6-7 days in the hotel. And now our staff, even the male staff, is staying in the house on the terrace. So we suggested that they stay put with us in the house. They don't go to the hotel.
Correct. How did you contract it? It's a question. I mean, we know, but you want to quickly just tell them?
Auntie, we could have contracted it through a lot of sources. We were doing this COVID lockdown ration bags and for the needy and for the helpless. So it could have been either that could have been the source, or we were in touch with the BMC officials and the Khar police station cops, providing them water and essentials. That could have been a source. Or then we had the NDTV media people staying with us in the hotel. That could have also been a source. So we don't really know any one thing that could have caused it.
Correct. One question. It is so scary in the way it's been shown in the news. Is it that scary?
You know what? It's actually not that scary. But again, you're listening it from me. I have no preconditions. But people who are diabetic, people who have, you know, like heart diseases, people who have BP issues, people who have dealt with cancer or are dealing with cancer, maybe for them, the symptoms might be quite bad. But for us, it has, touch wood, God's been kind.
Touch wood.
Yeah.
Okay. Talk about the immunity that you're giving to the kids, and how tough is it to handle yourself being sick with such small kids?
So
that's
that
a
was
very valid question.
Tough. Yeah, that was a little tough for a couple of days because this virus comes with a lot of tiredness, a lot and lot of fatigue. So when you're lying on the bed helpless, that you just can't get out of bed, that's when your kids come like crying to you and wanting to talk to you and play with you. And that's what's very, very troublesome.
I can't even imagine.
Yeah, at that time. And both my kids are very high on energy. So I'm actually, any which way, is a very low energy person. So so that was very, very difficult. And plus, nobody in the house could really take care of them at that point or entertain them at that time. And they're so used to a full house with everybody entertaining them and everybody taking up my elder one's studies. Literally one subject everybody does with her. So so for her also, it has been very, very difficult to deal with this whole quarantine issue where she can't meet her chacha and chachi and they are quarantined in one room and etc. But touch wood, we are all better now. So hopefully we can get back to our housey nights and get back to our singing nights on the terrace.
So the girls are with you in the room, right? They are with you.
Yes, Raya and Raina both sleep with me on my bed. Because there's no other way this can happen. They will not sleep with anybody else. And they don't, I mean, they cannot sleep alone. And Rahul sleeps alone. And my mom-in-law is alone. And Harshita and Monisha are also alone by themselves. So yeah, the girls are with me.
Nope. This is amazing. I'm more power to you for doing this, for coming on and talking to us.
But
I think
glad
a lot
of help, and in case
there's
they want
so many questions, but I think we've covered a lot. We've talked about what is virus shedding. We've talked about what you guys are doing for the sanitization. We've talked about what remedies you guys are using, medicinal as well as the natural one. We've talked about the immunity stuff you're giving the girls, and how you guys have all quarantined yourselves and the symptoms that you all have had. Yes, we are going to save this IGTV. I'm going to send this to Nupur as well, and I'm going to tag her so that she too can save it and share it. Lots of messages. Yeah, I agree. Very brave for her to come on and do this. if your daughter
my
has
younger
a wheezing,
daughter has a wheezing problem.
Yeah.
So every time she gets a cough, she also gets wheezing along with it. She's touch wood, never been on the nebulizer. I don't even know how to use a nebulizer. And she takes Astaline along with her cough syrup. So she is 20 months, so she takes 2.5 ml of Astaline and 2.5 ml of Tixilix.
So I think we've gone through the questions. I think we've answered all of them. Just a request, you know, one thing I think we should tell everyone, right? Like the minute you hear someone has the virus, you have 1,000 people messaging you, advising you, calling you up.
So that's why I had to do that Insta post today, because ever since my brother-in-law posted on Facebook last night, my WhatsApp and my calls have just been non-stop since morning. And I didn't even know what happened. Like, I woke up in the morning to so many calls and so many messages, because till then I did not know Monish had already posted.
Correct.
And so, yeah, see, guys, tips are very nice. Like, I'm not a bad person. I'm not saying don't give me your tips. But the whole thing is that you guys are talking from the other side of the virus. We've already dealt with it. We are already on day 10. And no, Rohini, you can't take Azzy at all. Because you're not supposed to take antibiotics. Even when the BMC officials came, the first question they asked if anybody has taken an antibiotic. So antibiotics are a complete no-no right now, because antibiotics can't do anything in a viral infection. And if you have a throat problem, then you have to just deal with it with a regular cough syrup. You cannot be taking an antibiotic. Okay. So yeah, so tips are nice. But we are already doing whatever we can. May it be your homeopathic medicine, may it be your vitamin C's, may it be the hot waters, may it be the steam. We are doing it all. So, I got a lot of questions even in the morning that should they test themselves? Like, there are a lot of their husbands who are not well. And their staff who's not well, and somebody in their house is not well. Very frankly, it's a very personal thing. I would say don't test. They don't have testing kits. Plus, what are you going to do by testing yourself? Because see, the moment you lose your smell and taste, you have a headache. A person like me who doesn't have headaches, I lost my taste and smell. I knew for a fact that I am COVID positive, and especially with Monish and Rahul being tested positive, I was 100% sure I'm COVID positive. There's no point in going and wasting another kit, because they don't have
absolutely
right now. So don't test yourself. Just quarantine yourselves in a room for 21 days, and I feel you will be fine.
Just one last question. They're talking about prescription. So did they have to get a prescription for the testing kits from a doctor?
Yes. That's another procedure. Like, your GP has to give you a prescription so that you can test yourself. So that also took them quite some time. And then even if my sister-in-law wanted to test herself, she couldn't, because then her procedure of her prescription would have started and all. And it's a very long procedure.
So they have told you?
Aparna, it takes 14 days for the virus to start showing. And from Rahul and Monish, it didn't even take us 14 days. It took us 2 days for the virus to show in us. And most likely, kids are totally asymptomatic. So, even if you feel your child could have caught it, she's fought it already, because she has antibodies for it.
So, 28 days, okay. Nopes, I must say, you look very amazing for someone who's COVID positive.
That's my motto, always look amazing. Corona or no corona, always look amazing.
This was so amazing for you to do this. We are going to save the IGTV video. Any questions? Vivo was most concerned. So he's coming to see Nupur aunty on this, because he was so concerned yesterday when I was talking to you on chat and I said it out loud, and he was like, "What is Raya doing?" I said, "Raya's fine." And so is Nupur aunty. So he came to see and he's gone now. Thanks, Nope, so much for doing this.
Welcome. Okay, anytime. Anytime.
It takes great courage. And I'm sure a lot of people are very, I think, happy to realize that the kids are at least fine, you know. Yeah, I think for everyone, sure, the biggest concern was the kids.
Yes,
and the kids are fine. Is fine.
And there's a lot of hype and panic around it because of what the media is sharing. Guys, also, it's very, very contagious. Okay, so I guess even the media's hype is quite understandable, because never has it happened that in our house with five people, all five people have got viral. Okay, so
it's absolutely
extremely contagious. And maybe the ones who have preconditions, because of those, that demographic or that group category of people, because of which we are made to go under this lockdown. But otherwise, very frankly, if you're okay and you have like high levels of immunity, you will fight it. And True. You will have your immunity passport to travel the rest of the world. So the faster
it is a great relief.
Yeah, the faster you get it, the better for you and for your entire family. And luckily for us, we've all got it together. So we'll all be bouncing back together soon.
Very soon, Nopes. Lots of love to you. Thank you for doing this. It is going to be saved and we're going to post it. I'm going to send Nupur the link as well so she can post it too.
Yes, I will.
Take care, Nopes. Bye. Love you.
Yes. See you. Bye.
Hey, guys. Thank you for logging into Live with Vi. Subscribe to see more videos.